Church here in Lithonia, Georgia, where the services will be held shortly for Vernon Forrest, well-known, renowned boxer who grew up in Augusta, Georgia, and was very well known here in the Atlanta area. Unfortunately, a few nights ago, he was accosted and murdered here in the city of Atlanta through a robbery. And now many mourners have come. Some celebrators have also come to celebrate the life and legacy of Vernon Forrest. This is Angelo Omar Muhammad for Hit TV and A1 Video.
My name is Charles Dawson. I was a personal friend of Vernon Forrest. You know, today is a sad occasion that we're putting one of my best friends to rest. We will continue to strive and live for the dream of what he stood for, of helping and giving back to the community. You know, his death will not go in vain. And, you know, we wishing the family all our prayers and, you know, and thank you for Hit TV for coming out here and, you know, showing the love and support. I feel that, you know, we as a community need to come together. I know that's what Vernon would have wanted, because he stayed in the community, you know, daily, wanted to give back. And it's up to us. And I feel this is a stepping stone of the community coming together, you know, because it's only two options. It can only get better or it can only get worse. And we're striving for it to get better. So his death will not go in vain. Well, I feel Destiny's Child was something that was very truly, it was dear to Vernon's heart. He didn't need no one overlooking, saying what he could and couldn't do. It was out of his own pocket. And he really loved those kids and everyone who worked for Destiny's Child. And I feel Destiny's Child will be a pillar of what you should give back to your community as far as the unfortunate and people that really need help. And it's something that will continue and to grow even more. Anyone that has anything to do with the case or knows anything about the case, don't hesitate to pick up your phone and call Atlanta Police Department, because, you know, it's you don't want that on your heart. You need to tell someone, because this needs to come to rest. They need to be brought in front of justice, and because it was a senseless killing. And we would appreciate that from the friends and the family.
I'm Davita Sullivan. I'm so happy to see the outpour of people that are here. You know, I was at the service in Augusta, and, you know, there was a lot of locals, but I'm really happy to see the support that Vernon has here. I know he would be really, really happy to have all of this, and I'm just shocked and saddened. I definitely think that, you know, that this will have, you know, a major impact. You know, me and Vernon would always talk. We'd always, you know, kind of go back and forth about different things, issues and everything. And I would always say, you know, some people have to die so that others value life more. And my big argument was, you know, why does someone have to die? Why can't we just get it? How precious and valuable life is. Why does someone have to, you know, why do good people have to go through things like this for us to realize it? So, yeah, I mean, that's the only sense. That's the only sense I can make of all this, is if something good comes in lowering the crime in Atlanta and the world over, you know, for our people. I think this is inspiration for all young people, for everyone, you know, disabilities, which is what he worked with Destiny's Child. But I think that this will have an impact on young people. I know, you know, at the other service they talked a great extent about the youth, and he was crazy about the kids and the youth. So, you know, I really think that this will have a huge impact on the youth, definitely. If anybody knows anything about this case, anything at all, please call the local police station. You can call in anonymously if you don't want to let anybody know who you are, but please, please reach out to the to law enforcement and let them know if you know anything at all about the case.
Well, I'm Reverend Reginald Maurice Copeland from Los Angeles, California, pastor of the House of Hope Church on Paramount Boulevard. We're here today to celebrate the life and legacy of a very good man in the person of Reverend Vernon Forrest. Brother Vernon Forrest, I've come to know him through a good friend of mine, Brother John Evans, who's on my right here from Augusta, Georgia, who was his right-hand man. I'm John's pastor, and we've known him for many years, and it is our hope and prayer that we would stop this genocide, this senseless killing Oftentimes, we often talk about what the white man or the white person has done to us, but black-on-black crime is not a white issue. And we must stop this genocide and begin to love one another and put peace and love back into our hearts so that we continue to grow and to love the Lord.
My name is John Evans, and from Augusta, Georgia. And Vernon was one of several champions that I'm with, and we're with Al Hammer Production, and he one of the biggest promoters in the world. And Vernon, I know Vernon from a child. Vernon come from Allen home of Augusta, Georgia. He moved from Allen home to Harrisburg. From Harrisburg, then he started training in Schaefer Gym, where he came to, he came a champion from the Olympic. And from the Olympic, he came to the WC welterweight champion.
My name's Shepard. They know me as Tiger. I met Vernon maybe 10 years back when I was doing music here in Atlanta. And he used to give me a lot of support, used to hang out with us and everything, and tell me, that I would make it just practice hard. And he was a really good guy, man. He hung out with my family a lot, come around and sign autographs and stuff. And I'm just coming out to, pay my condolences to him and his family. It's been a lot going on, lately with the crime, man. I mean, I've experienced it personally, with my family members, being robbed in the same, scenario, same situations. And we just got to have a lot of positive people come out and let people know that, we have to stick together. You know what I'm saying? Like us, this black-on-black crime and just crime, period, is not the way to go. Justice has to be served. You know what I'm saying? Because, we don't want any more hurt, any more families to be hurt. But, justice has to be served. Contact someone. Contact the police,
My name is Kirk Clark. I know Vernon through his work. I knew him through his work with his charitable organization, Destiny Children. He did a tremendous work in the community for children with challenges, artistic children, and he had a major impact in the community on the whole outside of his boxing prowesses. This is a very, very sad occasion